We've had a great evening of Western music so far, campfire music, trail music, timbertop mountain music, but we knew we'd better include some country music in the show.
We better have some country music in the show. Is there any country music fans here at the big show tonight? Yeah. I told you, Ranger Doug. And you were right. You said we got to have a country music song. Ladies and gentlemen, we've got a guy who can sing you a country song. Please make welcome Woody Paul Cyrus. Can I get some applause, please, for Woody Paul Cyrus? Can I get some screaming for Woody Paul Cyrus?
Thank you, folks. Thank you so
Everyone
very much.
Everyone throw one piece of underwear at Woody Paul Cyrus.
You know I don't wear them things. Thank you so much, folks. Y'all having a big time tonight? Isn't this a night of excitement? How about the riders in the sky? Aren't they something else? I believe they're about the best band I've ever seen in my whole life. Man, that fiddle player, he's really something, isn't he? We're going to do a little country music for y'all tonight. And, of course, the first essential ingredient in country music is to take the microphone out of the stand and pace around on the front of the stage like a big cat. And kind of shake it around a little bit. I figure it's a hypnotic move by the country guys to gain the attention or to maintain the attention of the audience, because in most cases the lyrics and the music wouldn't do it. So anyway, we got it going here. How many of y'all remember the old TV serial Gunsmoke? Yep. I've heard the old timers talk about it, and I never really saw it myself. In that wonderful long-running serial, there was one of those codependent, dysfunctional love affairs that lends itself perfectly to a country lyric. And we're going to do it for you here right now tonight in the setting of Old Dodge City. If I can remember how it starts.
It was dusty.
Oh, yeah, that's it. Now in dusty Old Dodge City, a barmaid called Miss Kitty had it bad for the marshal. Matt Dillon was his name. I've seen every TV rerun. Every time I've seen one, it's the same. He leaves her waiting for that kiss that never came. Yes, she keeps waiting for the sundown when he'll lay that smoking gun down. Swear to her his fighting days are through. But every morning Mr. Dillon's off to chase another villain, and poor Miss Kitty's wondering what to do. I'm telling you, one day you're gonna wear out your welcome mat if you keep stepping on her like that. You know that ain't no way to treat your kitty cat. You're wearing out your welcome. That's how you can tell a great country song. About a couple of weeks from now, you'll be sitting at your breakfast table eating your cornflakes and saying, why can't I get that stupid thing out of my head?
What is that? That's so gross.
That's the greatest country music move of all time.
Yeah, I got that from the great Johnny Cash, Ranger Doug.
I bet he was glad to get rid of it, too.
Well, now even Doc and Chester say, don't let this one get away. But Matt, you just ain't too quick on the draw. Why's a marshal treat her right? Tell her you can spend the night wrapped up in the long arms of the law. I'm telling you, one day you're gonna wear out your welcome, Matt, if you keep stepping on her like that. You know there ain't no way to treat your kitty cat. You're wearing out your welcome. Now, Matthew, I don't want to see the episode when Miss Kitty finally says it's time to hit the road. 'Cause everybody knows how much you'd miss her. So don't just stand there, Matt. Go ahead and kiss her. I'm telling you, one day you're gonna wear out your welcome, Matt, if you keep stepping on her like it comes a big money move, boys. You know there ain't no way to treat your kitty cat. You're wearing out your welcome. Yes, you're wearing out your welcome. She's sick and tired of waiting. There's a million fans watching. You better think about them ratings, 'cause you're wearing out
crush the stage. Woody Paul, sorry.